So recently I did a tutorial on the tool, but it's got a new feature, which is really useful that a lot of people miss. Let's check it out right now. So some people love the adjustment brush, some people hate it. And yes, you can do exactly the same thing with adjustment layers and layer masks. However, there's another feature in here which really makes it a lot more useful. Let's have a look at that right now. So I'm going to grab the adjustment brush. And maybe we want to brighten up our person in this photo. So why don't we go and choose exposure for that. So here's something that's different. Grab the selection tool in here. And if I roll over, I can see areas I might be able to select. Let's select our woman. Notice as soon as I do that, it creates the mask and applies the adjustment. So let's make some changes to this adjustment. Let's start with the exposure, which is going to give us our overall brightness. Let's take our offset, which controls our shadows and our blacks. Now I want to just kind of dial in something that matches the rest of the image. Maybe give it a slight boost in contrast. And then the gamma correction, let's pull that down a little bit. This kind of gives it a similar look to contrast. So we're going to reduce it a little bit. And let's hit that offset again. Now notice when I hit that offset, I get an area there which is too dark, it's too light. I need to be right in the area. Let me show you a little trick. What you want to do is go over the text, hold down the Control or Command key. And now I can click and drag on that text. Don't let go of the mouse. Now hold the Alt or the Option key. Notice now it moves very minuscule amounts, and this enables me to do those fine-tune adjustments. And this will work on any adjustment that has this box. I'm just going to bring these back. And the reason I'm doing that is there were hot spots on the skin that I didn't really like. And let's just fine-tune this offset again. All right, so if we look at this, there's our before, there's our after. Now I'd like to add that bag to the selection. If I grab the object selection tool again, and then I roll over the bag and I click, notice it gets added to the selection and takes on the same adjustments. We can see that in the mask. If I want to do the hat, we could do the same thing. Just grab this tool and click on the hat. Now it gets the same adjustment. Before, after. And of course, at any time, I can adjust all of this together just by adjusting the opacity. And if you weren't happy with the masking, you can always go into the mask there and touch that up. Let's have a look at a different way of using this now. So let's go to this image. Maybe I want to change the color of the background. So what we're going to do for an adjustment is we're going to choose hue saturation. Now, if we grab our tool here and I start to roll over, notice I can't select the background. I can select our model. I can select this book, the table, part of her dress, but we can't select the whole thing. So here's another thing that's kind of interesting. Let me just turn that tool off. If you look in the taskbar, you'll see apply to object. And we can change this. We're going to be using hue saturation. I'm going to grab the apply to object, and I'm going to drag around the objects I want to select. Notice now that it grabbed everything we wanted. It grabbed our model and all these areas. But I want to grab the background, so we're going to inverse the selection. So Control-I or Command-I will inverse, and now we're selecting everything else, which is our colored background. Now, if I want to change the background color, what we're going to do is grab this little finger in the hue saturation and click on the red, because I only want to change the red, not this gold. So notice that color is selected, and now I can change the hue. And if I want to make that something like a bluish color now, I can. And of course, we can adjust the amount of saturation. We could make that very desaturated if we want. With the lightness, we can make it darker, we can make it lighter. So I hope you found this tutorial useful and you learned something new. If you did, drop a comment underneath and let me know. And if you're new, welcome to the cafe. Hit the subscribe button, turn on notifications, and you won't miss any of my tutorials. Until next time, I'll see you at the cafe.